The national Jamaican fruit, ackee, has a truly unique taste. It's mild and buttery, and people who tried it say it tastes just like scrambled eggs. It's safe to eat ackee only as long as it's fully ripe. So the import of raw ackees was banned in the US almost 50 years ago. The only edible part is the white, creamy flesh itself. The pink flesh looks mouthwatering, but don't fall for it. It's highly toxic. Same with the black seeds. Soursop is one more fruit banned from the US because of its toxins. It's also referred to as guanabana and can release toxic substances, leading to some very unpleasant effects if not ripe. Soursop fans, don't be sad. Chances are, you might find some frozen pulp in supermarkets. Another thing that should be 100% ripe to be safe is elderberry. Raw elderberry is rich in vitamin C, which is good for you, and cyanide, which is not that good. These berries are quite popular though. You can find them in pies, syrups, teas, jams, you name it. Fully ripe and cooked berries aren't dangerous. And nope, it's not banned. Cyanide doesn't seem that serious when it comes to food with tetrodotoxin, which is 1,200 times stronger. Pufferfish is a Japanese delicacy, and it's loaded with the substance. No person can eat this fish without consequences, but Japanese chefs have mastered their skills to perfection. To make it edible, they simply remove the poisonous parts. This delicacy is called fugu and costs about $200 per portion. You could buy a whole bunch of totally safe salmon instead. It's almost completely banned in the US. There are only a few authorized places that sell it, but you probably don't feel like having such a gastronomic adventure either way. Kasu marzu literally means rotten cheese. Sorry, you can't try a bite of it in the US, so in case you can't resist the temptation, just head to the island of Sardinia, Italy. In fact, it's just sheep milk cheese with a pinch of, let's say, magic. Special flies leave their eggs right inside that cheese, and they stay there for 40 days. At the moment it's ready for consumption, this cheesy delicacy has some live maggots taking care of decomposing it. Thanks to them, the cheese has that distinctive texture and spicy flavor. It's banned in the US for sanitary reasons. Unlike soft and creamy Kasu Marzu, the Himalayan cheese Chirpy is famous for being the world's hardest. Just like any regular product of this type, it's made from milk. What makes it different is that it stays fresh for up to 20 years. The milk is quite special too. The cows, which are actually a cross between cows and yaks, eat a variety of mountain herbs. This milk has a unique flavor thanks to those herbs, but be careful with your teeth nibbling on that hardest stone cheese. In Singapore, you'll never have cavities because of chewing gum. And nope, it's not because they take care of your teeth. The thing is, it's completely illegal there. This place is known for its cleanliness, and the country spent a fortune cleaning all the spots and banning chewing gum. It was prohibited back in 1992, and vendors had to stop the sales immediately to avoid super high fines. Walking down the supermarket aisles while traveling to different destinations, you may spot that there's no raw milk in stock. It's prohibited in many US states and other countries, including Canada, Norway, Finland, Sweden, Denmark, and Scotland, for sanitary reasons. While raw milk is a no-go for Scotland, haggis is completely fine there. Still, it's banned in the US. If you live in the States and you're under 45, chances are you've never tried haggis, since it was prohibited almost half a century ago. This Scottish pudding is made of a full range of sheep's inner parts, mixed with some oatmeal and spiced up with a bunch of minced onions. Oh, and don't forget suet and some broth. The texture is crumbly and coarse, and no surprise, the dish is quite spicy. It's usually served with mashed potatoes or mashed turnip. Cassava is a poisonous tropical root with two types. The sweet variation does contain some cyanide, but it's enough to cook it to reduce the toxic content to a non-toxic level. To get rid of all the toxins in bitter cassava, it's necessary to grate the root, then soak it, and finally cook properly to make it edible. This root is very starchy, and its flavor is really subtle. Cassava can be used just like potatoes, mashed, boiled, or fried.
What you think? How about some haggis with mashed cassava instead of potatoes on the side?
By the way, harmless potatoes aren't that safe either. It all depends on whether it's ripe or not. So-called green potatoes are full of toxins, and potato sprouts are also quite unsafe. Same with green almonds and cashews, which are full of cyanide if not ripe enough. Luckily, the nuts we get at the supermarket are well processed, which means they're completely safe. Yellow plums, or Mirabelle plums, are banned in all the 50 states of America. These fruits are completely fine, and nothing bad happens if you eat them. But you can only enjoy these plums in Lorraine, France. The importation law is a bit bizarre, and this fruit is of protected origin. If sea bass is the kind of dish you just can't live without, then the UK isn't your destination. This fish has been recently banned there because of declines in the sea bass population. The same goes with beluga caviar in the US. One of the world's most expensive foods can't be found in America because of new regulations protecting the fish. Hey, feel like a burger with freshly cooked meat? The softest bun and loads of ketchup? Go and grab it. Unless you're a French school student, there's a law in France regulating the use of ketchup in cafeterias for students. And they're only allowed to have it with, you guessed it, French fries. Greenland shark bodies get rid of all the waste they produce, filtering it through their flesh and skin. So no wonder their flesh is toxic. Sounds like a fair reason not to eat them, but not in Iceland. Hákarl, which is processed shark meat, is first hung to dry for 3 to 5 months. In the end, you get something like ammonia-smelling fermented fish with the jelly texture that reminds you of wet bread. Some things get better with age, unless it's food. But there's one cafe in Bangkok where they've been cooking the same beef and noodle soup for 45 years. This potion-like soup has been simmering for over 4 decades. The broth has never been thrown away, and it's always kept overnight for the next day's servings. One of the secrets of the unique flavor is the massive grease rim around the pan that formed because they never washed it. Okay, now I've got the perfect excuse to do the same thing. What? The food just tastes better this way. In Cambodia, you can try a crunchy, crispy snack that tastes somewhat like a crab. It's deep fried and a bit seasoned. The main ingredient is a tarantula. This doesn't quite sound like a lunch. Okay, well, you wouldn't have guessed it if I hadn't told you. This soup that sounds like a tongue twister is definitely scrumptious. The flavor is sharp, yet delicate, and it tastes just like shrimp. Well, this traditional Laotian dish sounds really cool, until you realize it's made of ant eggs. To give it a bit of sourness, they also tend to add a few tiny ants. In Mexico, you don't throw away corn kernels that have turned black because they're rotten. You keep them as a culinary specialty called huitlacoche. Fungus all over the kernel give that earthy, woody smell. Yum, yum. Some dishes just need decoration, especially cakes and pies. In England, there's a pie called stargazy. The name speaks for itself. The sardines, accompanied by potatoes and eggs, peek out of the pie's crust and stare at the skies. And it looks a bit creepy. Sometimes it's the tails that point at the skies, though. Tea mushroom is another weird thing that they drink in Eastern Europe, together with acid milk-based drinks. It's basically some fermented black or green tea. It's made by adding a whole culture of bacteria. They're not consumed, they just ferment the drink. To sweeten tea, the sugar acts like yeast. Add juice, spice, or whatever you want to taste. Enjoy! Or at least try to. Tuna eyeballs are quite a popular delicacy in China and Japan. They need to be boiled before eating, and some seasoning is required too. If you nail it, you'll have a delicacy that tastes like squid. And it costs less than a dollar. I bet you're eyeing that one.